Good morning. Thank you all for being here. I'm excited to introduce this for a digital humanities crowd for the first time. I've done literature and culture, so I'm interested in your feedback and your comments. Can you hear me all right? Okay. So the title of my paper is Letters on and from Captivity, an analysis of the captive in Portuguese and Spanish epistolary writings in the 16th through 18th centuries. The main goal of this research project is to offer a new approach to the experience of captivity in the Luso-Hispanic world by focusing on private letters, because captivity is usually analyzed from official narratives or literary works. And these letters are not interested in reinforcing the imperialist ideas of the time. They were used as a way to get in touch with your family and friends and ask for, oh, can you exchange me for another captive that you have? So it's a lot more personal and, So I'm looking at the theme of captivity in private letters from firsthand accounts offers a new perspective on captivity studies. Specifically for this presentation, my goal is to discuss the differences and similarities between the experience of captivity in letters in the first person and in the third person. So when a captive is describing their own experience, how is that different from when he is mentioned in another person's letter? And my argument is that visualization tools that I'm using Voyant for this helps in noticing these relations. My access to the letters is only possible because of the PS Postscriptum project from the University of Lisbon in Portugal. They digitized private letters, most of them intercepted by the Inquisition, the church, military, and civil courts, because those institutions use these letters as criminal evidence. So if you attest to a crime that you committed, they could use that as evidence. And what they're trying to do in this project is to get close to the oral rhetoric of the time. But what I'm doing is like a textual analysis of the letters. For my research, I limited the search to letters with the keyword captive, which resulted in 23 letters. I only used the letters which the captive was in a faraway land and excluded the letters from the captive in their own country because I wanted to look at the relationship between us and the other and the barbarian. Having the transcript of the letters makes it possible to use digital textual analysis tools such as Voyant Tools. And I mostly use the Termsberry and Cirrus features. And it's important to highlight that Voyant is not supposed to substitute textual analysis, but it's a tool worth thinking with, and it augments reading rather than replacing it. And these tools create visualizations which transform the text with the goal of calling attention to a significant aspect or pattern, which brings me to Franco Moretti's concept of distant reading, where for him, distance is not an obstacle, but a specific form of knowledge. With fewer elements, we have a sharper sense of their overall interconnection and allows the reader to focus on units that are smaller than the text, thus helping the reader understand and interpret the text from a distance. So in this word cloud, you have letters in the third person that mention a captive. And we see that the words captive and man and references to geographical locations, such as India and Cairo, and mention to the Portuguese maritime expansion with the words for ship. And the main concern of these letters was to highlight the captive man and its connection to the maritime expression, not their well-being or what they were going through. And it also wanted to mark the place of captivity and where the letter was written. When we compare to the word clouds of the first-hand accounts in Portuguese and Spanish, we notice some terms have similar frequencies, such as senhor, sir, and mister, and I have, and por qué, which is because. But we notice that there's the presence of terms related to religiosity from family members and the suffering that prisoners go through. And this is not present at all in the third-person accounts, because that's not a concern for them. with the visualizations provided by Voyant, we can go deeper into the presence of religiosity, for example, and seeing how Deus and Dios correlates to other words. And then these terms are connected to prayers with the captives asking for health and love, for example. So the digital textual analysis using Voyant allows the reader to understand the differences between letters of captivity in the first and third persons, and what are the concerns of the captives when they're narrating their own experiences. We see that when they're the authors of their own letters, there's a lot more emphasis on religiosity, family connections, and the hardships of captivity, for example. And what I did later in my research was to do a close reading of these letters and see how this actually appears. But that's more than 5 minutes, so I won't be getting into that. Thank you. These are my references.